In a noisy bar, there is a person preparing to leave. Suddenly, they hear a gunshot. Everyone in the bar is frightened. People gather in front of the door, but no one dares to go out. At this time, someone sees the man's moving. He is still alive, but none of them dares to venture out to save him. A man in a green shirt can bear it anymore, getting out despite of being stopped. But they hear another gunshot. The second person has died. Everyone in the bar is intensely scared. Do not dare gather at the door anymore but run all the way back. They wait for a long time. There are no more gunshots outside, so they take a risk, trying to stand up. They turn on the television, wanting to see if there's any news about the shooting. They open all channels, but there is nothing about it. Andres thinks that it's still dangerous, so the media dare not report. Trini involuntarily looks outside. Then she is bewildered. The two death bodies are outside just now. Has disappeared. Even the bloodstains look like they've been treated, but they are completely unaware of someone coming. What are these things? They begin to analyze. Sergio guesses that there is a dangerous assassin in the bar. It is among them, for stopping the assassin not to escape. They can only kill everyone who comes out of the bar. Certainly the others do not believe it. This is too mythical. But in the crowd, Nacho starts to worry, staring at his bag, then going toward it quietly, using his legs to hide it. His strange behavior is seen by Sergio. He rushes over and catches him. The employee, Satter, takes the bag out. People question him what's inside. Nacho refuses to say. Satter is afraid that it's a bomb, so he don't dare open it. The owner, Amparo, rushes to grab it and opens it. Then she discovers there is only a smelly shirt and a hard drive in it. Why won't Nacho say it? Because there is a video in a hard drive, which is really important. He is afraid of being taken away by the assassin, so he hides it. Elena, pissed off, takes the hard drive and throws it to the ground. Crushes that hard drive. Nacho is no longer suspicious, but the beloved drive is crushed. He's angry, seeing the briefcase on the table. He says that briefcase can also contain bombs. Then he asks to open that briefcase, but now it is Sergio's turn to disagree, because that briefcase is his. Nacho can't accept that. Satter wants to control Sergio for the others to open the briefcase, but he is given a punch. Andres feels that the situation is not good. He instantly takes the gun out. Turns out he is a retired policeman, carrying a gun to defense. While the situation is tense, the crazy beggar, Israel, rushes over, getting the briefcase. He laughs frantically and opens the briefcase. This crazy beggar, holding a briefcase suspected of containing bombs. He immediately opens the briefcase, but everyone is confused. Inside the briefcase, all are women's underwear. It turns out Sergio is a pervert, likes to bring a bunch of underwear with him, so he dare not open the bag. At this moment, there is a sound coming from the toilet. Someone is hiding in there. Amparo remembers that, not long before, a man comes to ask to go to the toilet, but he hasn't come out yet. They have a hard time opening the door, but find that man sitting by the toilet bowl. He looks very painful. Everyone doesn't want to touch him. Elena feels that he is pitiful, so she can't help it. She comes toward to see his situation, but she sees a needle next to him. There is also a biochemical symbol in it. She can also see the blood constantly flowing from the man's ear. Elena is scared, so she drops the needle and leaves. But not long after, the man stumbles out of the toilet. They turns their heads, surprises to see the man's irises turn white. It looks terrifying. Suddenly the man falls to the ground. They quickly run over and then ask if he is okay, but the man only shouts that, "Don't touch him." Then he dies. They turn on his phone and look at it. They discover that the man is an officer. They also find a picture. People in the picture are wearing protective gear. Sergio says the information scared everyone. Surely the man has been infected with something virus, to keep it as a secret. That's why someone wants to kill people in the bar, who may have been infected. Next, Andres wants to take the man's phone, to call the police for help, but Amparo prevents him. She says it is the dead man's phone. There is definitely a virus on it. Andres hesitates. All of people in this bar, only him, Sergio and Amparo have not touched the phone. This thought has just arisen and is constantly expanding. Andres directly takes out the gun, asking people who touched the phone to stand together. But Amparo is still afraid of others infecting her, so she asks them to take the body together to the basement. Someone disagrees. Andres directly opens fire and threatens. This time, they can just follow the order. So five people have to stay with an infected corpse, locked in a closed basement. Because of the psychological effect, Trini feels uncomfortable immediately. She uses all of her strength to bang the iron door. She's not careful, spill a barrel of wine. But thanks to that, they find a sewer. They take off the lid, finding that the water below is not very deep, but it's all wastewater. It's very hard to smell. They don't want to come down, but Israel doesn't care. He immediately takes off his clothes. Take a barrel of oil and pour it on yourself. Since the drain is too narrow, he has to use oil to make it more slippery. Then he starts to creep in, but when he reaches the waist, he is stuck. Israel do not want to give up, so he asks others to push him down. These men use all of their, but they can't push him down. Finally, he has to give up, but at this time, he finds out that he can't get up anymore. A strong man, being stuck in a narrow drain, cannot go up and go down. At this moment, they all hear gunshots upstairs. They thought the other three are killing each other. They are about to get out. Then they hear many footsteps above their heads. It seems someone has come. Then they heard flamethrowers. Not long after, the smoke starts to spread. There is also firelight. Someone is firing this place. They quickly try their best to pull Israel up. After a while, they don't feel too hot anymore. The fire above must have been extinguished. So they sneaky open the door, discover the bar has turned into a ruin. They come out. Nacho found the gun, which is not burnt, and Elena found the phone, which was hidden under the plate, so they start looking for information, finding out not long before that, the man is texting with someone. He mentions, the 5 needles that he carry with, one has been used. They think it is the antidote. In the end, though, the man die, but they guess it's because he takes the medicine too late, so he can't survive. They start to look it on the death body, but they find nothing. Then they go back to the toilet. Discovered Israel has already found it. He doesn't say anything, but inject himself a tube first. Nacho is impatient. He is about to punch him, but he is restrained and Israel takes his gun. The medicine falls into the basement. Trini picks it up, but she carelessly drops it into the sewer pipe. They're screwed this time. Everyone gathers there, negotiating who is going down. Only Alina's body is the most suitable. Elena finally takes off her clothes, also pouring oil for the whole body like Israel. Then she also enters, but when she is going down at half, she's also stuck. Satter can only push her. Elena cries out in pain. It's very difficult to get in half. Satter again uses force for another push. Elena finally goes down there. Elena struggled with the smell to find medicine, but she certainly won't put up the medicine. Nothing they can do. Others takes iron pipes, intending to break the sewer pipe. Israel, who injected drugs, also comes to help. By that time Elena hides the medicine, she also sees 3 bodies, which is scorched through a hole. These people from above struggles to go down. They begin to go down one by one, but after going down, when Israel doesn't notice, Nacho immediately presses him into the water. He wants to kill Israel to get his gun back. After a fight, a gunfire flashes through the water. Nacho rises from the water, holding a gun in his hand. Looks like Israel is dead. Then Nacho starts to intimidate Elena, force her to give him the medicine. Elena agrees. Along the way, Trini also wants to play trick, taking a chance of darkness pushing Satter into the water, wanting to kill him, because the number of drugs is still not enough to divide. But in the end people still discover, the plan is broken. Trini knows she is not going to be given medicine. In order not to become like that man, she chooses to kill herself. They finally get the medicine, but they're just about to inject. They hear something coming from behind. They're going to run. Satter is beaten and die. It turns out that Israel is still alive, but Israel is beaten by Nacho, so he does not trust them anymore. He also prepares to kill them all. He starts chasing the two of them like a madman. The two also run quickly, but the gap between them is narrowing more and more. Fortunately, Elena finds a staircase going up. There is an exit up there. She immediately climbing up, but Israel is coming after them, non-stopping using the iron to hit Nacho. Suddenly, Elena misses the step, losing the needle. She ignores it, continues to climb. Finally reach the top, but could not open the manhole cover. At that time, Israel finally climbs up, catches Nacho. Nacho knows he can't escape, hand his needle to Elena, then grabs Israel and jumps down. Everyone wants to live, but in the end, only Elena remains. She injects the vaccine into her body. It is very difficult for her to climb. The street is now bustling again. That place is blocked. It is like handling a fire. Ironically, someone finds Elena pitiful, so she gives her a shirt, but no one knows how terrifying a battle she just went through.